Armchair Theatre, Vérité.
My name's Clive Young. I'm an actor, and I'm angry.
Come on, Shirley, you say something.
My name's Shirley Young. Well, I teach. The only reason...
What?
Well, nothing.
What is it?
Well, it's just that... Well, you sounded a bit phony.
I am an actor, and I am angry.
I know, but you were so sincere. You sounded phony. Well, don't be so self-conscious. Start again.
Good to start again.
Yeah. My name's Clive Young. I'm an actor. And I'm here today... Well, we're all here today because...
Well, now I'm really self-conscious.
Nigger.
What?
Do your nigger thing. Do the...
My name's Clive Young. I'm an actor. Now, a lot of actors think of themselves as actors, not workers. They don't care about the Industrial Relations Act. But I say to actors who think they're actors, you may think you're an actor, but the government thinks you're a nigger.
Oh, rubbish.
But you can edit that, can't you?
We never edit the truth, Shirley.
So I had this little thing in the New York Experimental Film Festival. It was very small, very personal. I'm really into personal cinema. Street. That was the name of the film. I'm really into uncluttered titles. I shot in this, you know, street. It's a hot summer night. There's prostitutes, transvestites. There's a guy shooting up heroin. There's a little girl peeing. It was very moody, very poetic. Hate it now. It's too structured.
But it got you the backing to come here.
Yeah, these two gay culture vultures ran me up out of nowhere. They said they caught my flank, blah, blah, blah. They thought I was brilliant, blah, blah, blah. Did I want to do a little thing for them?
Incredible.
Where does their money come from?
Schlock pop. They own a string of sleazy boutiques called the Green Noodle Company. We just thought it'd be so meaningful to help a young filmmaker. So Harvey and I hit London. A brilliant sound man.
Really? Mm-hmm.
What's the film about?
Well, I guess it'll be about the way I interact with London.
Don't you know?
Well, no, not for sure. I'm really into, you know, chance stuff, aleatory film. I just kind of walk around aimlessly and then wham, something will kind of give me a mental orgasm and I'll shoot it. That's real cinema verite, absolute truth. I mean, at the time, I may not even understand the significance of what it is that I'm filming, but when I put the footage together, it'll be an actual map of my psyche. Fascinating.
What?
A map of my psyche. I mean, the film will be a documentary about the inside of my head. A record of what happens to happen to me. Accidental. Well, that's a key word. Like meeting you guys.
It all sounds a bit unstructured.
It'll have a kind of structure, but it'll be the structure of chaos. I guess you can tell how much I've been influenced by Bruce Bonar.
Who?
Bruce Bonar. The guy who made Metadung. Haven't you seen it? Oh, listen, hunt it down. I mean, Metadung is a seminal film.
We're not wild about experimental films.
Sweetheart, we've only seen a few.
We saw about 50 that night at the new cinema club.
They were English. What do you expect? The English don't have an above-ground cinema, much less an underground one.
Well, you had Shakespeare. You can't have everything.
I'll start dinner.
This is my study.
Wow, you really have a thing about New York.
That's so much energy.
When was the last time you were there?
I've never been there, but everything I've ever read about it has turned me on. Well, anything's possible there. You want to make a film, you make a film. Here, it's so constricted, tired. I don't think we ever recovered from the war.
You better go to New York.
I know. For an adrenaline fix.
Harvey thinks you're a fantastic cook.
How can you tell?
I grok him.
Pardon?
We have a kind of ESP thing going.
Ah. What do you make of Clive's collection?
Far out.
It's very romantic about New York.
Not romantic.
You are very romantic.
I just think it's the centre of the earth.
Not romantic.
Isn't it, Ming?
Well, certainly the centre of pollution and crime. It's a terrifically violent city, isn't it, Ming?
Every new cultural idea starts there, doesn't it, Ming?
Pop culture may be, but nothing lasting, nothing profound. Am I right or wrong, Ming?
It's not just pop. The creative ferment is fantastic. It's amazing
vision. The tension must be unbelievable. Doesn't it frighten you to live there, Ming?
New York is heavy.
I bet it is. What is heavy exactly?
Oh, heavy is like...
It's like you read about a girl who goes walking in Central Park and gets raped in a gazebo. Or you hear on the radio that a guy shot his barber because he didn't care for his haircut. Or you're sitting in a coffee shop, right? An old man walks in wearing a black fedora, and when he takes off the fedora, there's a nail sticking out of his skull.
God.
So I thought I'd maybe take the green noodle money and run. I heard London was civilized. I was curious.
Fascinating. Isn't it, Clive?
We have to move. Harvey's crashing with some health freaks. They like him to go to bed early.
Wait a few minutes. Have a brandy.
Actually, darling, they want to make two.
Right. Taking off.
Where are you staying?
Victor's Paradise Hotel. Which is paradise. I don't know if you ever wanted to live in a horror movie. Last night I found some blood on the sheets. It's all right, it wasn't mine.
It sounds grim.
When Hollywood calls, I'm moving the door to this stuff.
Look, why don't you stay here with us? Well, to put you up in my study, we love to put people up. We put people up all the time, don't we, Shirley?
We do.
Are you sure?
Oh, we'd love it. It'd be a sort of little commune. It'd be super.
We'd love it.
Wow. Oh, wow. You're beautiful.
Nothing.
No, I mean, I thought the English were such tight asses. I mean, nice, but...
They are.
Well, you're not. You have some beautiful stuff.
I'll make the bed.
Let me drive you to the hotel. Then we can pick up the rest of your things and drop Harvey.
I wish I could film you right now, man. You're so beautiful.
Darling, it's 2.
Sorry. Nick and I were rapping.
What in?
Rapping. Deep talking.
Better buy me a dictionary of American slang.
He's smashing. Don't you think he's smashing?
Mm.
It'll be tremendous having him here.
How long will he be with us?
I don't know. A couple of weeks, maybe. He's so interesting. God, he's interesting. Do you know, he's only 26, and yet he's... He's crammed so much in. He was in Paris in 68, filming. He showed me a picture of himself being gassed.
Carries a picture of himself being gassed?
Says it's a kind of passport for when he talks to radical kids. Show them that he was in Paris for the Avenimal. What's that?
What's what?
That little smirk thing.
I didn't smirk.
Yes, you did. You made a sort of smirk. You do that sometimes.
What?
Smirk.
I do.
Yeah. Someone says something that makes you feel condescending. You don't actually say anything, but you go, smirky.
Sorry.
I don't think you should smirk at Mick.
I shouldn't, and I won't. Just hope you won't fawn.
Fawn?
Yes, you know, hang on to everything he says and agree very intensely. Well, fawn.
Fawn?
It's something you do with Americans. Let's make a pact. I don't smirk, you don't fawn.
I don't remember fawning.
Right.
Hi, Shirley.
Hey, Shirl.
Listen to this. Mick's written it for the film.
I'm gonna sing it over shots of Victor's Paradise Hotel. Whatever happened to the garden? Paradise has disappeared. The fruits and flowers are on fire now. With the flame of history, they're seared. Mama, mama, won't you help me? The day of judgment is at hand. The garden's turned into a desert. My blood is flowing on the land. On the land. The desert stretches out for miles, blazing with a million suns. The mountains are 100 miles away. They look like melancholy nuns. Mama, mama, won't you help me? My head is dangling and dry. The nuns are holding out their arms now. If I don't get to them, I'll die. I will die.
That's super, mate. Great. What do you think, Shirley? Super.
Super.
She hated it.
No, I thought it was very good.
But not super.
Maybe not super.
Oh, come on, it was very good.
I said it was very good.
She just didn't think it was super.
Well, I tell you what worried me. It was a bit Bob Dylan-ish, and Leonard Cohen-ish, and a little Joni Mitchell-ish.
Well, I liked it.
And rather Carole King-ish.
I thought it was very good.
She's right, it's derivative.
I have this critical mind.
And some beautiful stuff. No, it's not good enough, no way. Come on, Harvey. Let's move out to Wegmans. See you tonight, Shirley.
Mm. He's a nice boy.
Great.
Harvey's a bit strange.
Mick says he has a very strong inner life.
Oh, I don't think that glazed look in his eye comes from spiritual peace. He's on something.
Why couldn't he just have a strong inner life?
This is the 20th century, Mac. Nobody has an inner life. God, that tea's foul. When did you make it?
I can't remember. We've been up for hours.
Rapping.
Blimey!
Coming!
What's happening?
Mick wants to film me before the matinee.
Oh, congratulations. You're on the map of his psyche.
We're an island culture, and we have an insular island mentality. I ask you. London likes to think of itself as the theatre capital of the world, and yet this is the typical product. I can vouch for the total awfulness of the thing because I'm in it. 2 hours of sexually repressed giggles, and the Sunday papers call it revitalizing. New York wouldn't stand for it. We're an island culture, if you can call it culture. How was that?
Super.
Hi.
Tired?
Yeah. Nice kind of tired. We shot some good footage today.
Beautiful city. Very photogenic.
Right.
Cherry? Tidied up your room today. I hope I didn't misplace anything.
You shouldn't have bothered. I like a mess.
I don't. I'm one of the tidy people.
My mother's like that. Real neurotic.
I'm not neurotic. Just tidy. How did Clive do?
Very good.
He can be quite articulate. Was he articulate?
Very articulate.
What did he talk about?
Oh, things. Theatre. You know.
He was good?
Very good.
Good. Oh, if you ever want to film at my school,
Shirley,
let me know.
Shirley, do you think we could have something else on?
Oh, sorry. Do you hate Leda?
Is that Leda?
Yes.
I hate it.
Funny, Clive does too, I suppose. It's all those years of hearing his mother sing Hark, Hark, the Lark at garden parties.
Mozart, Bach.
You got the Stones?
Oh, sure. Excuse me. Don't you like serious music?
That is serious music. It's about today. Those 19th century boys, they lay old 19th century sound waves on you. It's like films and theater. Film is pzzz. Theater is little.
Come off it, Mick. Art transcends.
Art? Give me anything, but don't give me art. What the hell is it anyway?
Art is the process
Stop.
By which map.
Words are a mind trap.
Mick!
That's not a hassle. I like Mozart sometime.
He'd be chuffed if he knew.
Compared to the Stones, he's irrelevant.
Oh, Mick, for Christ! Is he all right?
Oh, yeah. He just can't take conflict. He's into serenity.
Oh, that's what it is.
Ever since 2001.
Eh?
Kubrick's film. Ba-dum, ba-dum.
I'm with you.
He saw it about 1,000 times. For Harvey, it was practically a mystical experience. I mean, he'd been psyched up for years, and suddenly he got interested in the universe. He'd sit for hours and try to reach Jupiter with his mind.
Did he ever get through?
Yeah, eventually.
Talks to people on Jupiter?
Well, not exactly talks, but he's picked up noises. Cosmic static. He's pretty sure it's a message.
And what do you think?
Well, I'm open. I mean, Harvey's certainly hearing something. Whatever it is, it's really made him very tranquil. And tell you the truth, he used to be pretty weird.
Have you ever considered the possibility that he might be crazy?
Surely. I used to believe in flower power and pot. I used to believe in violence and revolution. One month, I even believed in God. So why shouldn't I believe in messages from outer space? You know what I'm saying?
You're saying Mozart is irrelevant.
Oh. Hello? Hmm? Who? Yes. Wait a minute.
Mick! Mick! Call from New York!
5 o'clock in the morning.
I'm Mick Collins. I think it must be Harry. He must have got my cable.
Harry?
One of the green noodles.
Harry, hi, man. Did you get my cable? He got my cable. I'm fine. I'm staying with some beautiful people. Oh, you knew that. I put in my cable.
Cabled him, we're beautiful.
Hey, listen, I've got 2 weeks of great footage, but I can't have it developed. The bread didn't arrive. What? Get in touch with who? Can you write this down, Clivey?
Yeah.
Hold it, Harry. I have to get some paper.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Get in touch with Kehile Gosh. How do you spell him, Harry? K-I-H-A-I-L. Gosh. 93 Davis Street. Will he have the bread? What? I can't hear you, man. Cut off. He's supposed to send me some bread every week. He didn't want to give me a lump sum. I suppose it's a way of keeping tabs on me. I wonder who this Gosh is.
Probably a bank, don't you think?
Sorry, but I have to be up at 7 in the morning.
Oh, right.
I feel wide awake now. You feel like rapping, Mick? Fantastic. Shirley,
You have some beautiful stuff.
Welcome. Excuse the mess. We've just moved in, huh? If you wish to smoke some pot, light up. Oh, in Manhattan, his employers were ever stoned.
I don't work for Harry and Charlie.
But they have written to me saying that you are the authorized London agent for the Green Noodle Company.
No, man, I'm a filmmaker. They're just sponsoring my film. They told me to get in touch with you. I thought you were a bank.
No, I'm not. I see what it is. It is the famous American pragmatism, huh? I detail. The Green Noodle Company has ordered from me $50,000 worth of kaftans. Hot item in Manhattan. Majestic city.
Very majestic.
Those mountainous skyscrapers, your redoubtable Empire State Building, it blows the mind.
Fantastic place.
Caftans.
Yes, yes. The renowned American directness, always to the point.
Huh? Right.
This is the first time Green Noodle deals with me. They worry. An Arab burned their fingers last year. Happy solution, you. They have sent me a check for 50 tau. But until you scan the goods and approve them, the check is not valid. You, the authorized London agent, must countersign here. Then I give you $5,000.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Again, wow?
Business freaks are total down.
Oh, right. No. Your friends are charming fellows. They merely beg a favor. A quid pro quo.
Well, how the hell did you check a caftan?
They have sent you a list of instructions. I will give it to you when the time comes.
Well, hasn't the time come?
Unfortunately, our North African workshop has been temporarily closed by the police because of an adjacent cholera epidemic.
The caftans have cholera.
No. The goods are A number one okay. A well-placed fiver will bring a clean bill of health.
When?
Cholera has been invoked. The matter is subtle.
When?
He's almost out of film.
A little weak. A speck in the eye of the cosmos.
I hate my nose. It's so bloody neat. If only it were thick or bony. Or thick and bony, then I'd be right for so many other parts, not just upper-class twits.
I could break it with your cricket bat.
I hate the play.
You've waited 5 years to be in a West End play.
It's a mistake. Going through that mindless crap every night, it's absolutely demoralizing. Mick's right.
About what?
The only way to live my ideals is to get out of the commercial theatre. Join the fringe, do street theatre, rep, anything but this.
Is that what Mick thinks?
Yeah.
Mick also thinks Harvey talks to Jupiter.
I know, fantastic, isn't it?
Find it credible.
I'm open. Why reject new ideas out of hand? In New York,
they certainly... I can't bear it when you go on about New York. Even Mick couldn't cope with the violence.
He'll go back. He'll miss the ferment. The English will put him to sleep.
Well, I know two English people who are not only putting him to sleep, they're feeding him and giving him pocket money till Mr. Gosh's boat comes in.
What's the use of whoring in the West End if you can't help your friends?
Whoring? On the day you landed that part, you were one happy prostitute.
And that shows how screwed up I am.
You weren't screwed up till Mick arrived.
All Mick did was point out my internal contradictions.
What about his internal contradictions? He seems quite prepared to live off your immoral earnings.
He's getting this out of proportion. Mick is simply raising a few questions.
Why is it that whenever we put anyone up for a few days, they wind up convincing you you're a bourgeois creep?
You hate anyone to criticize us. And if I happen to agree with them, you act as if you caught me committing adultery.
Well, it is a kind of adultery. It's philosophical infidelity.
Oh, Shirley! If you don't start opening your mind up to new ideas, you're going to turn into your actual Islington ostrich.
Hey, you all right?
I've just had an incredibly moving experience with the reprint.
Do you want to talk about it?
Yes.
Damn it! That's it. I'm out of film. Hi, Shirley. This is Barbara Ziskin. Isn't she too much?
Hi, wow! You're everything Michael said. He just loves you.
Oh, well, I knew he liked my stuff.
Oh, I can't wait to meet Clive.
He's very nice.
Hey, do you tap?
No, I don't, actually.
Well, listen, I took it up after my divorce. It's fantastic therapy. You know, I saw this floor. I'm just gonna get into my tap shoes.
Fantastic. Wonderful.
I just know we're going to see a lot of each other.
We are?
Yeah, Michael's asked me to move in.
Your seconds, folks.
Armchair Theatre, Part 2, Take 1. Beautiful.
Is she a beautiful cook?
Brilliante.
They got some beautiful stuff.
Oh, stupendous stuff.
I knew that the moment I started filming them. Mm. Wham! These guys are something special.
Incredibly special. Shirley and Clive. Shirley and Clive, I have to tell you how incredibly warm and giving I think you are. I just had to say that.
Beautiful.
And I have to say something else, too. I'd like to make love now. You know, the emotions I'm feeling for this man cannot be contained. Well, you understand. You're such an intuitive person.
Wow. She's really a passionate woman. I feel close to you.
I like her. She's very open.
Open's the word. I'm relieved they went downstairs. For a moment, I thought they might have each other on the table.
I think that's terrific. I mean, she felt something and she expressed it. Well, we're not like that. We keep things bottled up, but Mick and Barbara,
they're very open.
Exactly.
I was a wreck, a total mess. I mean, I had to get out of New York. My DQ was incredible. Distress quotient. It got to the point I thought everyone was ripping me off.
Is ripping like rapping?
Ripping off is like stealing, only heavy stealing. Like we used to say, the government is ripping off black people. Did you say that here too?
Clive's a political one.
And you're not?
Not really.
Well, that is great. You're not and he is? That is so great that you worked that out. In New York, the marriage would be over, you know.
Oh, I think London's less intense.
Yeah, New York is very intense. Oh, sometimes it gives me the crazies and I have to get out. I mean, suddenly, to get so paranoid. It was the full identity crisis number. I had to look at an alternative lifestyle. Well, that's why I came here. I remembered how civilized it was, you know?
How did you meet Mick?
Oh, it was stupendous. Get the picture. I'm sitting on this fountain, tears streaming out of my eyes, right? Surely, those Rembrandts at the National Gallery, they destroyed me. The insight, the compassion, brillante. So I'm sobbing on this fountain. And he starts to film me, Mick. He's a total stranger, but the man senses that I've had an extraordinary emotional experience. And I have to talk about it. Fantastic. Surely, he's so wise. He makes me feel like a child. Have you ever gone to bed with a man half an hour just after you first met him? Stupendous.
Don't think I'm that liberated.
No, there was such connection, such caring. And he has a fantastic body.
Hello. Hmm? Who? Yes, yes, wait a minute.
No.
Mick, Mick, New York. Oh,
damn it.
Well, they're 6 hours behind us there.
This had better be Harry and Charlie. Yeah.
Bruce! It's Bruce Bonner.
Who?
The Metadone Man.
Oh, stupendous film.
Yeah, London's heavy, right? I'm staying with some beautiful people. Oh, you knew that? How did you know? Harry and Charlie told him.
It's all over New York.
So what's happening over there, huh? Oh, you're kidding. Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, wow, that's fantastic. Well, listen, I'm gonna have the rough cut for you in about 4 weeks, okay? Right. Peace.
Bye.
I can't believe it. Bono wants to show my film this summer at MoMA.
Oh, Michael!
Museum of Modern
Art. Oh, that really is too fantastic, right?
It's the Young Filmmakers Festival. It's the one to be in.
Stupendous.
It's fantastic.
Super.
Screw Harry and Charlie. Where's the damn bread? Oh, I only have half a film.
Oh, these guys are so sincere, and they wear blue jeans, and they're into all these radical causes, and gay liberation, and alternative lifestyles, and this and that, and they're still bloody business freaks.
Poor bastard.
They're never going. Mick will never finish his film. He'll live with us forever.
Sound like an old woman.
Can't help it. They're aging me.
I don't understand it. Mick and Barbara are so vital. Why didn't you find them in Ritchie?
Well, for a start, because they've already cost us about 50 quid.
What's money got to do with it?
Oh, look, supporting Mick was one thing. Okay, he was broke, but Barbara wears Gucci shoes and zonking great pieces of jewellery and Paris clothes. She's been here a week. She hasn't bought so much as a bottle of beer.
That is so petty.
Look, Clive, you aren't living with your parents in some Surbiton fantasy anymore. We've put all our money into this house.
All my money.
All right, your money. But it still means that 50 quid ain't petty.
You really sound like the ultimate bourgeois bitch.
Thanks. But that's a bit closer to the mark than your famous ostrich analogy. I wish I was a damned ostrich. I wouldn't have to teach and shop, cook all the meals, clean up after our beautiful little commune.
The sheer martyrdom of it. Our lady of the housewives.
Good morning.
It's great to stay up late. Good morning. See you.
I told you she was too much.
Well, the point is, if that's so much money, what do I need with it? My ex is a very generous man. Though, well, I'll be doing something constructive and solving my identity crisis at the same time, right?
You see, I can't wait for gosh. This way, I can take the whole schmear to the lab in 2 weeks.
I am going to be a producer! Isn't that wild? Well, it's selfish, really, because when Mick described to me what he shot so far, it sounded so brillianty. I just had to say.
You're going to produce Mick's film.
Yes,
I told you she was too much.
But what about the green noodle?
Oh, screw him.
Oh, but that's terrific.
Yes.
You'll be through in a few weeks, then.
Right.
Oh, that's super. That's super, isn't it, Cheryl?
Oh. Yes. Oh, that's... Isn't that good? Well, we'll have to celebrate. I'll make a super dinner.
Good.
Oh, can we have Harvey?
How could we not have Harvey?
Can I do something too?
Oh, it's not necessary.
I'd like to.
Oh, well then, do super.
For the dinner.
Thanks.
Do you know what it is?
Very short spaghetti.
Sandalwood jazz sticks.
Lovely.
But I will.
Shirley. Harvey's here.
Good.
He brought the two guys he's staying with. Is that all right?
Of course.
Great. Okay, Harv. Mwamba Duwumi.
That's his name. And this is Carlisle. Carlisle.
Carlisle, fantastic!
I told you about Carlisle, darling.
No, you didn't.
We've all been really up for meeting you.
Anxious vibrations.
That's probably because none of us ever met a witch before.
Warlock, dear.
Harvey says you only do white magic.
Mm-hmm. Healing, good luck incantations. May I have some lamp, please?
Certainly.
Have you ever done any black magic?
Oh, for ages. My grandmother was a black witch.
Oh, why did you give it up?
It was in Leeds, dear. This person moved in with me and was given all my attention and love.
Yeah.
And then I discovered that this person entertained a football player in my absence. It was in the early days of my career, of course, before the lectures and the books. I was still working at Austin Reed. But when I discovered that this person was unworthy, I decided it should die. Mince Austin.
Sorry.
Thank you. Yes, well, my grandmother helped me select the proper formula. And we were setting up the altar, and this person rushed into the room and began to cry. Well, in the candlelight, it looked just so beautiful. I told it to go, I wouldn't kill it. Oh. Just give it leprosy. This lamb is delicious, dear. What do you put on it?
Mustard. Fanny Craddock.
I want the recipe.
Did you really give him leprosy?
I'm afraid I did, yes. It works in a factory now. His face is totally disfigured.
Oh, my God.
I destroyed somebody's beauty out of pique. And after I'd done this dreadful thing, I forswore black magic. killed my grandmother. You're not a believer, are you?
No.
No. No. A witch, my dear, is simply someone with advanced mental powers. An evolutionary freak, a mutant. And as for being in touch with the devil, well, that's a load of crap. Theological window dressing. The devil read nature.
Sorry.
Shirley has trouble with new ideas.
Carlyle, I wonder, would you... I'm not sure if this is the right word. Bless my film. You know, give it a good luck incantation.
I'd be honored. Right after the pud.
Queen of the water, queen of the earth, bring to thy bosom this child of promise. Blessed be, O goddess, everlasting to eternity. He, O Evo, she, blessed be.
Hi! Love a cup of tea, Cheryl.
What are you doing up?
Well, you said you wanted to get an early start.
Babsy,
what?
You know what a producer does?
Mm-hmm.
She stays in her office all day.
Oh, not this producer. This producer's gonna be out on the streets helping.
Listen, filming is a stress situation. You have a high DQ.
I'll be totally supportive.
Why don't you stay home and help Shirley? She comes home from school, she has to do all the shopping, man.
I'm fine, Mika. Cook.
Michael, I'm coming along.
You sure?
You look so peaceful, I don't want to bother you.
What happened?
Nick was filming this fat lady singing. Well, all I said was I saw the same lady in Darling with Julie Christie, and the man went rigid. He said, why didn't I go home? He absolutely withdrew his love.
He's tense. He said filming was a stress situation.
I was giving him love. Now, that is not easy for me to do. You don't know what a long time it took me to learn to do that. I mean, Shirley, you cannot imagine what a bitch I used to be when I was married to Carl. I used to imitate his stammer in front of his mother. I told everyone what a small penis he had, which was true, but what a thing to say. Oh, no wonder he tried to run me over with a Mercedes. I was such a hostile person. It took me years and years of analysis to move beyond the hostility. So when I offer the man love and he refuses, it's like an earthquake in my guts. Am I blue? Am I blue? Ain't it tears that I'm telling you?
Well, she's really into possessiveness.
She bailed out the film.
Well, yeah, she's beautiful, but possessive. I can't have her around when I'm filming. I gotta get her off my back.
You better talk to her, Mick.
She's been down there tapping for hours.
I hate heavy scenes.
You know, if he gets her off his back, she's gonna jump straight onto mine, it being the handiest other back.
You don't understand.
No.
Look, Babsy, have you ever been in a tunnel with two lanes for traffic? And one lane is closed, so all the cars have to travel down the other lane. Well, that is what my love is like. It's like a tunnel with two lanes, only when I'm filming, I close one lane. My love for other people, and all the cars have to travel down the other lane. So I wasn't withdrawing love. I was just closing one lane.
But I was giving love.
Oh, there was a kind of reverse selfishness in the guise of love. You went on an ego trip, man. You were trying to show you knew better than I did. Your love was like a tunnel with both lanes open, only it was like a painting of a tunnel. And not even an original, a forgery. A painting of a painting.
Oh, that's brilliant. Mick, I have to say something, Mick. Thank you for that.
Good. Well, I don't want you to be down, Babsy. I just have to work alone.
I understand.
Besides, it'd give me more time to be with Shirley. I've been neglecting her lately.
Well, you could do her a lot of good.
I know. She's on a very low level of consciousness.
You really dig Martha. She's wry like you. Great sense of humor for a lesbian.
Look, Barbara, I must get through these essays.
Essays? Really? Hey, what are they on?
Description of a male relative over 65.
Oh, that's very structured, isn't it? I thought the primary schools over here were all so free.
You can't be really free unless you have a sense of structure.
Mm-hmm. That's a very interesting point of view. You know, all this time we've had together, I have learned so much just listening to you.
Have?
You've given me fantastic insights into a totally different lifestyle. You're a very structured person.
Quiche.
No, I think you should learn to be a little looser. Because, well, you got so much beautiful stuff already. If you were just a little looser, you'd be stupendous. I think that you should get interested in your body. You know, we did 3 months on our bodies in group therapy. By the end of that time, I was really friends with my breasts. Fantastic.
Glad you like it.
I am going to give you a sense of your body. And one and two and three and four and turn and two and three and good and turn and two. Good, good, three and four. Yes, no, turn. Yes, yes, and four and one and two and three and good, good. Keep going and three and right.
Oh, thank God it's you. Thought it was time for a tap lesson.
Is everything all right?
Slight overdose of vitality, nothing fatal.
Mick's finished the editing.
Oh. Oh, that's good.
He wants to film you tomorrow.
Me?
He says it'll give the film a better shape.
Oh, fine. Then it's finished.
Mick says no film is ever finished.
But it will be as far as we're concerned.
I shall miss him. Both of them.
Suppose I will too. After they've gone.
Shall we go down to Brighton on Sunday?
Oh, well, yes, that sounds, I was gonna say beautiful. Oh, yes. Ozone, then peace.
Yes. Peace.
This film is for all of you. You've all become part of my psyche and helped me to understand what it is that I'm filming, so I dedicate it to you with love. And especially Shirley. Okay.
London is dying.
They want to kill me. they want to kill me.
Why do I love London?
Well, I suppose...
Because it's still possible to live in peace here. To create a sanctuary.
You white bastards keep coming down in this place looking for trouble. You're gonna get one of these days.
Send them all back. And if they don't want to go back, put them into camps.
If you can call it culture.
All cities are dying. They are being destroyed by the very technology that created them. Man will turn more and more to the occult, to the secrets of nature and the universe. We are seeing the death of reason. Die, cities! Die, reason! Die, Western world! Let man be reborn!
But what exactly upset you?
I suppose I feel betrayed.
Betrayed?
No, wait. Yeah, go ahead.
We put you up, fed you, then you go and make a film like that.
A film like what?
Well, first of all, I look like an idiot.
You're real eloquent.
And right after I finish speaking, you cut to a shot of a dog turd.
But that symbolizes your spirit in the midst of all the horror.
Well, you created the horror. The film is so distorted, it's like Nazi propaganda.
Come off it, Shirley.
That's not London. That's the last 20 minutes of the Roman Empire. Maybe New York feels like that, but not London.
I shot all that footage here, man.
The way you put it together, not to mention what you left out, you might have squeezed in one picturesque muse.
Listen,
for God's
Shirley.
Sake.
Shirley. When I came to edit the film, I realized what my psyche had been trying to tell me. London is New York. There are no alternatives. All cities are New York.
The West is dying.
Oh, excuse me, but you're a homosexual witch. Your viewpoint is somewhat special.
No, it's true, Shirley. Now, I haven't been here in 5 years. There's more traffic, more garbage in the streets, more poverty, more new buildings, more pollution.
Barbara, I do wish for once you'd be quiet.
Shirley, now, don't be hostile. I'm trying to make you a gift of my perceptions.
Thank you.
Now, I've been through all this in New York, the decay. Do you know what was so brillante about the film? The sirens and rah, those people talking to them.
Barbara, please.
Oh, they're like storm warnings. Now, I've been through this. First, you begin to notice sirens before breakfast, during dinner, when you're making love.
I'd really rather not hear any more of this apocalyptic rubbish.
Then you begin to notice something else. More and more people in the streets, they're talking to themselves. More and more people in the city are crazy.
Barbara, shut up!
Now, Shirley, I've got to say something, Shirley. You're a very hostile person underneath.
Oh, God!
No, but as the city collapses, you'll mature. You'll find you have to reach out to other people. You'll move beyond hostility.
We don't hear sirens, we hear bells, church bells. There's a canal down the street, a square, flowers, birds. Birds are in the square, fish in the Thames. I know my butcher. I smile at my neighbours in the Camden Passage. This isn't New York.
You getting your hands?
Beautiful.
At school, my kids make me little presents. Little bits of paper jewellery, chains of pins, bracelets of hangers. In New York, they throw teachers into closets and they rape them.
Can't you get any closer? The look in her eyes is really freaky.
But if anything, the city's getting better. The air is getting cleaner. Food is much improved. This is the music capital of the world. The Mall is closed to cars on Sundays. Oh, what about our theatres?
It's a putting fantastic.
It'll be brilliant.
Listen, I think I got enough now.
Yeah?
No.
Why didn't you say something? I needed you.
But I thought the film was accurate.
Accurate?
Not literally. More like a prophecy, a vision. It would take someone from New York to see where London is going. The idea that we're more civilized is a myth.
But the film wasn't true.
You just don't want to know. You're so cozy in this middle-class ghetto, you can't see the abyss opening up outside the gate.
An abyss in the center of London. Do you think anyone's told the Department of the Environment?
You don't want to see it, so you'll never see it. Things are breaking up.
Things are in transition. It's what's known as history. But they're breaking up. They've broken.
Vanquishal region. Avenger smoke goddess.
Suppose you want to talk to Mick Collins. Right, I'll get him.
Mick, Los Angeles calling.
That was the green noodles.
They've surfaced again, eh?
Yeah. Harry was furious when he heard about Gosh. But then, of course, Mick was furious with Harry.
Sounds a charming phone call.
It was okay in the end, because... listen, they've actually bought Mick a script.
That's a little structured for Mick, isn't it?
Well, he always knew he'd have to compromise in the end to make a big film.
Natch.
But it sounds a smashing story. It's about this... it's a modern Jack the Ripper set in New York. This English guy comes over, upper class, sort of... defeat right-wing homosexual, starts killing off all these blacks and Puerto Rican guys.
Super. Definitely a cut above the West End. You will play Jack, I hope.
Mick wants me to. My contract's up in a month, so I'm free.
How long will you be gone?
It's difficult to say. If everything works out, quite a while.
Dream come true?
Yes.
You sell the house?
I thought you'd stay on.
I don't think so. Ghosts, you know.
Well, I'll ask Preble to sell it. We should get a good price for it. We'll split the money.
Fine. Kept thinking you'd laugh at them in the end. Affectionately, but you'd laugh. You'd laugh just once. We'd have been all right. And you never had much sense of humour.
We wouldn't have been all right, no way.
Damn it, we would have. They finished us. I thought the function of an artist was to bring order out of chaos. Mick brings chaos out of chaos.
Even by your own elitist standards, what about Picasso,
Joyce? For God's sake, Clive! Our marriage is in ruins. This isn't the time for an aesthetic discussion.
You began it.
Oh, piss off! Piss off! Leave me alone! Piss off to New York with your chums and their tap shoes and their cameras and their microphones and their Jupiter and their egos, their craziness. They want to create chaos. They adore chaos. That's an illness. It's a kind of plague. They're carriers. They should be belled. God! They're so bloody efficient at transmitting the disease. Where the hell am I going to find a cure?
I love London. Well, I suppose, because it's still possible to live in peace here, but to create a sanctuary. I think Clive feels that too, really and truly. I honestly do. How was that?
Super. Cut. Fin. Finito. The end.
Thank you.